Lightsabers are one of the most iconic visual effects, and modern editing software like HitFilm make them relatively simple to create. Achieving Hollywood-level results from home has never been easier. However, there are some common mistakes you should avoid, and some underused techniques that can make your effects stand out above the rest. One of the most common mistakes with lightsaber visual effects is jittery motion tracking. Manually placing the lightsaber effect nearly frame by frame is a common practice, and is often necessary for fast-moving lightsabers where there is a lot of motion blur. However, manual tracking like this is very time-consuming, and not very effective for more close-up shots with slow movement. This jittery, inaccurate tracking is quite distracting and greatly reduces the quality of the overall effect. Instead of tracking these shots by hand, try using HitFilm's motion tracking features. This allows the software to lock onto the details and track their movement for you, saving a lot of time and creating a much smoother result. Once you have a solid track on the core of your lightsaber, the second most important element is the glow. HitFilm comes with many different glow effects, and it's easy to just drop one on, change the color, and call it done. By spending some more time customizing the settings or even stacking multiple glow effects together, you can achieve a much more realistic glow. Not all glow effects are created equally either. Some of them have more customization options or a different falloff that affects the realism. If you have HitFilm Pro, I'd highly recommend the Super Glow effect, as it is super easy to get a great looking glow. If you're in HitFilm Express, I'd recommend stacking three or more regular glow effects with increasing radius settings. Rotoscoping, also known as masking, is an essential aspect of any lightsaber effect shot. An often overlooked detail is that the lightsaber blade should not cover the lightsaber hilt or handle. HitFilm's light sword effects have rounded ends, which can work in some cases, but your lightsaber effect will feel much more real and integrated into the shot if you take the time to mask out the hilt. Another detail to keep in mind is that glow effects should be applied after masking. A lightsaber is a bright stick of light, and if it is being blocked or occluded from the camera's view, there shouldn't be any glow in that area. A common mistake is to apply the glow and then cut out the mask, but this isn't realistic and doesn't look quite right. One detail that is often overlooked when filming a lightsaber video is the lighting, or more specifically, the brightness of the lighting. Lightsabers often get lost and washed out when applied over a bright background. This even happens in the movies, like this shot from Star Wars: The Phantom Menace. Darth Maul's lightsaber is in front of the bright desert sky and looks very dull. Compare that to these shots from darker scenes. The lightsabers stand out much more and generally look much better. If your lightsaber duel needs to take place during the day, try to avoid the lightsaber going in front of the sky, as it is easy for the sky to become overexposed to white, meaning your lightsaber won't show up at all. A great way to make your light-based VFX feel real is to film with interactive lighting. It is possible to fake this lighting with more visual effects work, but nothing beats practical lighting on set. This detail is only really present in the newer Star Wars movies, but it makes a huge difference. Having the colorful lightsabers illuminate the actors and surrounding environments makes the scene much more dynamic, and makes the visual effects feel grounded in reality. You can use prop lightsabers that actually light up, or you could use small RGB lights to create a similar effect. But if practical lighting isn't within your budget, you can always say that you are trying to match the style of the prequels or originals. Be sure to check out our various detailed tutorials to learn how to create your own lightsaber effects, and subscribe for more content like this. See you next time!